Hi everyone, welcome to my PHP tutorial video. In this video, I'm about to explain how to make a table with Autofilter. Along with this video, you will also learn how to merge cell and set cell style using array. Let's begin. Here, I have prepared a mockup student data in JSON, which consists of ID, first name, last name, email, gender, and class. To make things easier when working with this library, it is recommended to first make the template in Excel for what we are about to make. It's better than imagining things as we code because with this we have some sort of guide. Our table will consist of ID, first name, last name, email, gender, and class. Now let's make it look a bit like a proper table. Now let's do it in the script. I'm just gonna copy this to save time. And remove this unnecessary code. First, change the default font like usual. You can do it using get default style and then get font and set the name to Arial, and also change the size to 10. Next, let's do the heading. Add the heading tag using set cell value at cell A1, and then merge the first row into a heading. In merge cell method, we use a cell range as a parameter, and all cells in this range will be merged. Let's try it out. As you can see here, cell A1 until F1 have been merged. What I'm gonna do next is to center the alignment and then increase the font size to 20. Let's change the font first. The name of the merge cell is gonna be the first cell in range, in this case A1, and then get the font and then set size to 20. Next, we're gonna do the cell alignment. Alignment is a part of the cell style, so we call get style and then get alignment and then set horizontal to horizontal center. Just like what we have learned from previous tutorial, this constant is a part of alignment class, so we need to also call the alignment class in this script. Please refer to the documentation for more options. Perfect. What we're gonna do next is to set the column width. Rather than imagining the number, let's do it in our guide. So it's gonna be 5, 20, 20, 30, 12, and 10. Let's just put it down here so we don't forget it. Now let's do the code. Width is a part of column dimension, so we get it first using column name and set the A to 5 and B to, oh I forgot, oh 20 and C to 20 and D to 30 and E to 12 and F to 10. Good. Next we're gonna add the heading text, change the font, and make it bold. But first, we need to add the header text. I'm gonna speed up the video because this process is repetitive. Next, I'm gonna change the fill color to this color and the font to white. Let's do this in the script. Now we're gonna try a different way to style a cell by using arrays. Let's make the styling array first at the top of the script, just after the class loading. You can either use square bracket like this or use array built-in function. I'm gonna use square bracket here. Now setting the font properties. Setting the color. Using RGB and make it white. And then the fill properties, setting the fill type to solid using fill solid constant from the fill class, and then set the color using RGB. I have looked up the color code beforehand, so I'm just gonna put it here. And finally, use this array to style our cells using apply from array method. Whoops, I used the fill class but I forgot to call it in the script. Let's fix it. Now as we have used the array for styling, these two codes is a bit redundant, so let's move it into our array. And the heading is done. Next, I'm gonna add the content. I wanna make the fill color alternate between even and odd rows, like this. And for that, I'm gonna need two style array. Let's make it. For even row, I name it even row. I'm just need to set the fill here. And for the other row, I'm just gonna copy it and change the color. Next, adding the content. My data source is from JSON file, so I'm just gonna get the file content and use JSON decode. Of course, you can use database for this. Next, looping the data. We need to make a variable to hold the current row number. This number will be incremented in every loop. And then set the cell value from the data source. Next, setting the cell of the current row. Here, I'm using modulo operation to distinguish between even and odd number. And don't forget to increment the row number. Perfect. Next, I'm gonna add an autofilter. In Excel, to make an autofilter, we need to simply select the range of the table and then click on filter. And Excel will recognize the topmost row as a filtering row like this. Let's do this in the script. We need to define the first and last row of the table range. And then add the autofilter simply using the setAutofilter method. And we're done. This concludes this chapter of tutorial. Thank you for watching. I hope this tutorial is helpful. I put the link to the source code in the description. Feel free to ask anything in the comment section. Please kindly like my video and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next chapter.